Hey guys, now you can follow me on Facebook. Just go to facebook.com/UltraMaximusReviews. Hello YouTube, Ultra Maximus back with another toy review, and today we're going to take a look at another DC Multiverse figure. It's Alfred Pennyworth. So I found this at my local Walmart here in Greenwood, Indiana, on the south side of Indianapolis, and I gotta say, I was surprised to see it. They had the entire wave of this Collect and Connect series for the Killer Croc, and to be honest, this is the only one I was really interested in. The only other figure was the Red Robin figure. I think that looked pretty cool, but I had to get this guy because it's either the coolest figure or the dumbest figure or both. I mean, it's a Butler action figure, but what it's got a lot. So let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging. So here we have Alfred Pennyworth in the packaging, and I gotta say, this makes me want to go out and buy another figure, really. The reason for that are the alternate heads that we get here. I'd like to get one of each and have the two versions of Alfred. I think they just look really, really, really nice, and I haven't even gotten out of the box yet. But the packaging itself's the new look for the DC Multiverse in the blue. We get some Detective Comics artwork right there of Alfred. It's got the DC logo at the top. It's got the 80th anniversary of Batman in the top left corner. He's got his Collect and Connect piece in there. We got the alternate heads. The fact that we get three alternate heads is nice. He's got a bat cowl, a glass. He's got his tray. Side of the package has got the artwork of Alfred right there. And then that side's got the same artwork. So just kind of a close-up as usual. There's the DC logo. And then there is the Batman 80th anniversary gold stamp. Looking very cool. And then here we have Alfred with all of his accessories, which is ridiculous. I definitely dig that. And then, of course, it's a multiverse figure. And then here's the artwork on the side. Back of the package here, it's got a little write-up up here that says, Alfred Pennyworth is butler, medic, soldier, friend. There's nobody more important to Bruce Wayne than Alfred Pennyworth. That almost makes it sound like it's some kind of bio off of My Little Pony versus a Batman, but whatever. And then here are the other figures in this wave. You can make Killer Croc, and I really just don't care for this version of Killer Croc, and it's kind of sad, really. And, you know, looking at all the other characters, the only other one I was interested in was the Red Robin down here. And I passed on it. I had to get Alfred here. So just kind of a close-up. There's the Killer Croc that you can build. And then there's the Red Robin, Batman. Who's at the Red Hood? Now, I notice the Detective Comics Alfred here has gray hair instead of black, which is different. We get Katana there. And then who's the one on the top? I don't even know who this guy is right here. If you know, leave a comment down below. I'm not even sure who that is. But that's pretty much it for the packaging. Let's go ahead and get Alfred out of box and see what we think. So here we have Alfred out of the packaging. And I've said this a bunch of times. This is either the coolest figure ever or the dumbest figure ever, or both at the same time. But I'm really digging this figure because it's Alfred, damn it. It's Alfred. And we don't get a lot of Alfred figures, and this might be the best Alfred figure that they have put out, which is a really weird thing to say. So first and foremost, he does come with a Collect and Connect piece. It's part of Killer Croc, and it looks pretty decent. The hand goes up and down, twists around. It's got a single joint there. There's a hinge joint right there, and then it twists at the upper arm. Basically the same kind of style you see in any Marvel Legends Bat figure. You know, and that's being said, with Marvel Legends, DC Multiverse has really stepped up their game. Mattel's been doing a good job because the articulation and most of the figures since the Shazam release have been on par with Marvel Legends. This guy right here is none the different, and he comes with a bunch of accessories. He's got a whole bunch of different head sculpts, and then he comes with, and I want to kind of show this off here if I can. I don't know how well it's going to show up on camera. He's got a little tiny glass. This thing could get lost so bloody easy because not only is it tiny, it's transparent plastic. I've almost lost this thing on the rug I don't know how many times, so be aware of that. The other cool thing is he comes with a serving tray, and then he's also got a Batman mask right there, so it's got just the cowl, it's the front part, so you can put that on the tray, and he's like, here you go, Master Bruce, here's your bat mask. So that's kind of cool, and it's very reminiscent of the Batman 1989 Tim Burton film, which is awesome because, well, it's one of the head sculpts. So we get the four different head sculpts on here, which makes me really want to buy multiple Alfred figures. I really just want to get one additional because there are two of the heads I really like and the others are kind of eh. But I gotta say, this is the only one I've ever seen out in the wild, so they're pretty hard to find. The figure itself comes with the comic book style Alfred head already on there, which is meh, it's okay, it works, I guess. But what I really like are the two additional Alfred heads that it comes with. The first one being the 1966 Alfred head sculpt, which is awesome because if you have the 1966 Batman figures, you can easily put him in there with that, which is great. I love that. I'm just going to throw his head over to the side. The one I really love, my personal favorite, it's the 1989 Tim Burton Michael Keaton Batman head sculpt. This will probably be the Alfred that I use. Love that. Love the glasses on him too. And then the last head sculpt, I believe this is the Outsider or Earth 2 Alfred. So if you read the comics, Alfred has become evil a couple times. One, you get an evil version of Alfred that's kind of pale like this in Earth 2 where he serves Owlman. And then he also becomes the Outsider where he gets some supernatural powers. He gets killed and brought back and he's kind of like, you know, from Pet Cemetery, I guess. But every time I see the evil Alfred, he's always got the kind of little round hat on there. It would have been kind of nice if he had that on there. I would have preferred that, but eh, it's probably a repainted head sculpt from something else. That being said, I'm sure this is a Joker body. If it's not, it's going to be. Very, very easy to put into a Joker paint scheme, which is fine. It works. Now, as far as articulation goes, with Alfred, he can move his head back and forth. It goes down really, really far. Looks up pretty darn far as well. He's got an ab crunch that goes down about that far. It really doesn't go back very far, which is unfortunate. He's got a twist at the waist right there. Arms do move up and down. They do go outward like that. There's a twist at the upper arm. He does have a double jointed elbow, which is nice. His hands do twist. There's a hinge right there. His legs kick that far forward. They don't kick back much at all. There is a twist at the upper leg. Legs kick all the way out. If I can get it to focus. There we go. Looking good. Go Alfred. He has a double jointed knee, which is crazy sauce. No swivel at the upper leg or anything. The feet are on a hinge joint and they've got that crazy ankle rocker pivot we love! With this being his widest possible stance with both feet still flat on the floor, which is a bit of a shame because his legs do splay out quite a bit, but to be honest, how dynamic of poses are you going to put Alfred in? Come on, let's get serious. So taking a closer look at the figure itself, here we have the comic book style, and I want to say this is the Jim Lee style of Alfred, and it's pretty good. It looks like Alfred, it looks like he does in the comics. I like the sculpt design. The outfit is basically a Joker costume repainted in black. I like how he's got his kind of male pattern baldness on the sides there, and he's got his little bald spot on the back. I think that works really well. The jacket sculpted nice. It's got all the wrinkles where they need to be, and then you got that leverage around the arms that can move, and it really doesn't look out of place. Like, he's got a vest with his arms going through it. I think they did a good job at the sculpt work to make it look like a one-piece jacket. And here we have Alfred, which I think this is the weakest head sculpt. It's the Outsider or Evil Alfred head sculpt. Very ghoulish looking, which he does look in the actual comics, but his whole flesh tone is like that. I mean, it's painted well, it looks decent, but every time I've seen him in the comics, he's had a pencil-thin mustache in this motif. And he's usually got a hat. Now, I did like how the back of the head here kind of goes to more of the flesh tone, like it's more of face makeup or something on the figure so that it kind of blends in with the neck, because he would look really weird with just this ghoulish face and a flesh tone neck. I mean, I guess it works, but it's by far the weakest of the four head sculpts. And then here we have the 1966 head sculpt, which I think is really damn cool. I mean, they really captured the look of the actor that played Alfred back in the 60s. Looks good. Love the glasses. Love the paint. Everything is on point here. This is my second favorite of the head sculpts because I love the old 1966 show. And the fact that there are so many of the 1966 Batman figures out there, you know, this goes perfect with those figures. I love the option that you get there. But yeah, man, they really, really nailed the likeness down on this. Kudos to the sculptors and digital artists, because this looks damn good, and it looks like it was meant for this figure. And then finally, my personal favorite head sculpt is the 1989 Tim Burton, Michael Keaton Batman Alfred. I just love this interpretation of Alfred. I always have, because I'm a huge fan of that show since I was, you know, a teenager. And I mean, again, they nailed the look of the character. The glasses are great, the flesh, all the paint on it, the hair. It looks like the Alfred from that show. Now, I will say on this particular body, I don't think it matches the body type as well as the 1966 Batman head sculpt. It's just a little bit too thin, but I mean, it works, and it works well. I've got the Nika 89 Michael Keaton Batman, and this is definitely going to go up on the shelf next to him. So looking at the midsection of the figure, again, sculpted really well. He's got his little butler outfit on, all the wrinkles. He's got the gloves, the cuffs, the jacket. I like how it's kind of open. We got the buttons. The, you know, vest is gray, matches the you know, gloves. Although when I think Alfred with these gloves, I usually think of white gloves, but meh, is what it is. Again, all of the wrinkles in the jacket look really, really good. He looks like a butler, or the Joker, if you repainted it. And finally, taking a look at the legs of the figure, again, the jacket kind of splaying out with the tails there. The pinstripe in the pants looks good. He's got the gray socks to match the gray vest and the gray gloves. Everything matches. And then he's got his little loafers. It stands pretty well, which is really, really nice. I was kind of afraid that this guy wouldn't, but hey, they did a good job. For comparison, here we have Alfred next to Aquaman. I don't have a good Batman figure laying around my stage. This is the closest thing I could find. But again, this is another really well-articulated multiverse figure. And it's kind of cool to see them side by side. I guess I could do a Batcave with all the Justice League in it. No, this is just weird. This is a weird comparison. But it kind of shows you his scale, I guess. Get it? Scale. Scales? Scales? These are the dad jokes. They're not getting any funnier, folks. So is it the DC Multiverse Alfred a figure that you want in your Batman collection? Absolutely yes, you want this guy. It's Alfred, first of all. Second of all, we don't get a lot of these figures. And thirdly, they nailed this thing. Not only is the body sculpted well, we get four different head sculpts. We get the classic comic book. We get the Alfred here from the 1989 Batman film. And we also get the Alfred from the 1966 TV series. So regardless of which Batman fan you are, whether you're from the comics, whether you're from the old 60s show or the movies, you've got an Alfred for your collection. Plus, you've got Evil Alfred. So if you like Owlman, you've got, you know, Outsider for him. I mean, this thing is great. Probably one of my favorite figures of the year. If you see him, pick him up. I would like to get at least one other figure so I could have a 66 Alfred and the 89 Alfred. This one's going to go up with my Nika Michael Keaton Batman that's in the same scale. And I've got a couple of the 66 Batman and Robin figures from DC Mattel. I think the 66 Batman or 66 Alfred would be great with. I mean, if you see it, just buy it. It's friggin' Alfred. So there he is, Alfred from DC Multiverse by Mattel.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, thumbs it up. If you hate this video, thumbs it down. To watch more Ultra Maximus, click on the links to the right. Don't forget to subscribe and share, like us on Facebook, and look for more videos in the future.